for the first time since the pandemic began, a family physician is facing restrictions accused by Ontario's medical regulator of spreading misinformation about vaccines and other public health measures. Tonight, the allegations and why one infectious disease expert says the consequences are too little, too late.
Just showing conflict between doctors, even if it's 10,000 to one, that provides a lot of impetus for someone trying to choose. Who do I believe? Do I believe science or do I believe Facebook?
The physician in question is Patrick Phillips. He has a family practice in Northern Ontario and describes himself on social media as a small town doctor and lover of freedom. Many of the allegations are linked to his Twitter account, which has close to 40,000 followers. The College of Physicians and Surgeons of Ontario accuses Phillips of making misleading, inaccurate, or inflammatory statements about vaccines, treatments, and public health measures. And as of midnight, the doctor has been barred from giving out mask and vaccine exemptions and is banned from prescribing certain medications for the treatment of COVID-19, including the antiparasitic medicine ivermectin. Toronto epidemiologist Colin Furness tells City News he believes there should be harsher consequences and more enforcement when it comes to doctors and misinformation.
I have submitted more than one complaint myself based on observations of physicians in the community, sometimes on Twitter opposing vaccination and so on and so forth. It doesn't feel like the college responds very strongly. That's a mistake in my view. That's a gigantic mistake. Any doctor who makes a public statement opposing vaccination, in my estimation, should be suspended.
Patrick Phillips is the first doctor that's been referred to the disciplinary tribunal for pandemic-related concerns. And according to the college, Dr. Kulvinder Kargil, a GTA physician, has been cautioned three times this year for her tweets about public health measures. The college also posted a statement on its website regarding the spread of misinformation, saying that doctors hold a unique level of trust with the public and that the information shared must not be misleading or deceptive and must be supported by a available evidence and science.
It takes only a tiny number, a very tiny number, to suddenly stand up and oppose vaccination, to propose cocktails of their own, to go off label with medication, in some cases maybe not even approved for human use. And it doesn't take many of them to really invigorate and energize a fringe group.
Now, we did reach out to Phillips on his social media accounts, but did not hear back. He did, however, address the allegations in a tweet, writing, "Never have I been more proud of myself than the day I decided to take a stand against our country's medical tyranny." And the college also claims that Phillips has refused to cooperate with their investigation. A disciplinary hearing will be held at some point. At this time, though, no date has been set.